this stuff. But the rich one, young ruler, he said, I keep commandments, but I believe really if you read into that, he was looking for more. And I think that he decided not to have the courage to come out of that cage. I believe that he decided to stay with the things that he knew, thinking he had it all, but in the end finding out he had nothing. See, Jesus said, follow me. He could have been with the apostles. Think about the apostles. Okay? These guys, they saw Jesus do miracles. They saw, the fishes and the loaves. They saw healing. They saw all these things. They saw the crucifixion. They saw Jesus after the resurrection. They saw him ascending to heaven. And these were ordinary guys, right? But they chose to come out of the cage and live dangerously. And back in that time, the average person would live and die within 35 miles of where they were born. But yet, because they were not afraid to be bold in the Lord, they had an opportunity, and Jesus sent them to the corners of the world. And think about that, because most of them would have lived and died within sight of the Sea of Galilee. But instead, I think they went to, Peter went to Italy, I believe it was. John went to Asia. Even Doubting Thomas went as far as India. So see, because they weren't afraid to come out of this cage, that they had this awesome opportunity, because they didn't say, I've got to be in this cage. And as Christians, keen Christians, I think that there's a lot of times discouragement that comes along when these legalistic and religious things are put in front of you. Because God wants that relationship. God wants to know you intimately. And although we need to have boundaries and margins and all these things in our life, it doesn't mean that if you accept Jesus Christ, that's the end of the world. Well, they're a Christian, cross that off. We need to show the world that being a Christian is the better thing to be. It's not a disappointment, it's a victory. It's not something to be ashamed of, it's something to brag about. We have a choice to make, just like that rich young ruler. We can stay in our cage and end up with everything and realize we have nothing, or we can come out of our cage and live from that adventure of pursuing God. See, this message is really not about a spiritual journey for you or for me. It's about the Creator, the Father, wanting to write His story through our life. And we have to allow Him that. I mean, let me back up and tell you a little bit about this. Okay. 53 years old, and well, 30 years old. But I'm going to tell you, I feel great because I'm going to tell you, it's a process. It doesn't happen instantaneously. But as you develop a relationship with God through time, spending time with Him, studying the Word, and all the things that your preachers teach you, then you begin to trust Him more. And as you begin to trust Him more, begin to not worry about the day-to-day things. Yeah, you got to have a job. Yeah, there's boundaries and margins and laws. But you know what? God will take care of everything if you trust Him and follow the Spirit, the will of the Spirit. And the way you find that out is to be through a relationship. So teens,